Hello everyone, welcome to Rasayan Academy guys, and this is our 21st video. And guys, the name reaction is Rupe rearrangement. So as you can see, this is a very simple reaction, and very quickly we are going to talk about the reaction as well as the mechanism. Okay, yes, so it is acid catalyzed rearrangement of tertiary alpha acetylenic terminal alcohols leading to the formation of alpha beta unsaturated ketones rather than the corresponding alpha beta unsaturated aldehydes, right? So what are we talking about over here? That you have tertiary, focus on this, tertiary, so yes, tertiary acetylenic alpha acetylenic alcohol, matlab ki on the same carbon you are having the acetylenic group, matlab ki an alkynyl group and the alcohol. Okay, so on the same carbon you have both of these reactive groups, and yes, in the presence of acid, finally the rearrangement gives you alpha beta unsaturated ketone once again, and not the aldehyde. So you are not going to have the alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde because a ketone is a more stable possibility. Why is that so? We are going to see that very soon. So yes guys, before moving onwards to the mechanism, I would request you to share the video guys, share all of the videos if you think the content is good. And yes, we have reached 21 and we have kept a target of 100 name reactions. We are quickly going to achieve that, and definitely if you are liking the videos, if you are able to understand anything, then please do share it guys and keep on interacting. It means a lot. And let's see the mechanism. So how is the mechanism? Ye dekho, we are going to have the acetylenic group as well as the alcohol on the same carbon. So in the presence of hydrogen, in the presence of a proton, we get the hydronium ion formation. The hydronium ion formation, definitely you know what is a good leaving group, and when it leaves you are getting the carbocation formed. Now the carbocation, since it does not have any other possibility, the only major possibility is the removal of the proton to give you the alkene, right? So this proton could be removed, right? This proton could be removed as well as this proton could be removed. So here we are having the same possibility, both of the hydrogens are the same, so whichever you remove, you are going to get this type of an alkene system. Okay, what further can you see? Further, since acid is present, so the alkyne group can take up a proton and it can give you either a carbocation like this, or here is the selectivity, or it can also give you, right, it can take up a proton on this carbon and it can also give you a carbocation on the primary sp2 carbon. But yes, you know that this possibility is more stable, and hence we are going to proceed with this possibility. Water is going to attack on this carbocation system and it gives the enol, which is further going to tautomerize into the alpha beta unsaturated ketone system. So yes, the question here is, why are we getting the ketone and why are we not getting the aldehyde? Because this intermediate is less stable. Now if you had the water attacking onto the primary carbon, then you can say, all right, then you can say ki you are having the enol like this, and the enol further on tautomerism gives the aldehyde, isn't it? Yes, but the aldehyde possibility is not so good, there is no resonance, and also this carbocation is less stable, so the product is going to go through a more stable carbocation, which is the secondary carbocation. All right, so I hope that you have understood the mechanism. If not, then you can stop the video, try it by yourself, and now we'll be practicing some good examples, as you can see. All right, so here we are. So about the first example, this is our first example, and what do we see? We see the alcohol and the acetylenic group on the same carbon. And definitely in the presence of an acid, what do you get? You get the formation of hydronium ion once again, and I hope that you are doing it by yourself, stopping the video. Yes, no cheating guys, you have to learn, right? So this is what we have. Now further, yes, now further, what do you expect? You expect the removal of a proton, but here we are having two possibilities, and these are two different possibilities. One possibility is the removal of the secondary proton over here and the primary carbon proton. Now the question is, which proton removes the one which is going to give you a more stable alkene system. Why is that so? Why are we having the SageZef alkene over here? The more stable alkene is more substituted, called the SageZef, and the less substituted like this is called the Hoffmann alkene, Hoffmann product. But why are we not getting the Hoffmann product? Why are we getting the SageZef product? Because the reaction takes place in the presence of acid. Acid makes sure that you are having the most stable carbocation, and the shift is definitely going to be from this hydrogen. So in the acidic medium, make sure you have the SageZef product. Now this is not the final product because it still has a reactive alkyne group. So what do you see? What else do you see? You are going to have the proton taken up by the acidic by the alkyne, and definitely the proton goes on the terminal carbon, so that you have the carbocation on the secondary carbon. Now further, when water attacks over it, you are going to get the OH. And on ketoenol tautomerism, you further get the ketone, right? So yes, all of these are a little bit of a right. So from here you are going to the alkene, from there you are getting over here, then here, and then finally over here. So this is your final product that you are able to see over here, right? So this is again the alpha beta unsaturated ketone, and this is going to be our major product. Okay, yes. Now further, we have another example. We have another example over here, example number 2, and this is equally very, very important. Why? Because here, as you can see, on one of the alpha carbons you do have a proton, on the other alpha carbon it has a proton, but it cannot be lost to give one more double bond over here, isn't it? So what do you see? First of all, as always, the OH is going to take up a proton, it's going to leave. So let me just directly start with the carbocation over here. Yes. And guys, it goes without saying that you have to be honest and you have to do the mechanism by yourself. So whenever I come to a new example, just stop the video. Okay, I don't have to say it. Okay, right. So here we are, the carbocation. Now further, we have two possibilities. What are the two possibilities? Again, this is the proton, this is the alpha proton, which could be lost to give you something like this. It is going to change the double bond position. It's going to be here, right? Yes, there is a carbon over here like this. Okay, and the double bond is right over here. So if the proton is lost, you are getting another double bond onto this side. Let me just draw it. Yes, so this is how you have the double bond, one of the double bonds from the removal of the proton, which is closer to the carbocation. Very well. Now okay, you get a cross conjugated system, but let's say if we are removing this proton, okay, let me just show it with a different pen, might help. Yes, so when we are removing this proton, there is going to be conjugation like this. So let me just draw the system once again. So if you have, let's say, alright, so there was the double bond, there is a carbocation, and this is your alkyne system. Yes, and ye ho gaya isopropyl. So if you are losing this proton from here, a double bond forms in between these two carbons, so definitely there is resonance. And yes, what do you get? You get something like this. Now this is a extended conjugation that you can see over here. This is an extended conjugated system, right? And you already know that extended conjugation is more stable as compared to the cross conjugation. Here it is cross conjugation, all right? And here the whole portion is extended conjugation, and definitely, as you already know, in the presence of water, this alkyne group is going to be hydrolyzed, and further it is going to give you a ketone. Yes, it's giving you a ketone, just like the same mechanism that we had previously done. The most important part of this reaction is the formation of the extended conjugation system and not the cross conjugation. So your major product goes through the more stable intermediate, the extended conjugation one, right? So I hope, guys, that you understood what is Ruppe rearrangement. It's a very, very simple reaction, and I hope that if you like the content, then don't forget to share the profile, guys. That would be really, really great. And this is all I ask from you. Please do share, right? And I'm trying to put up all the important name reactions just for you guys, so that you can get some free knowledge, all right? And definitely score good in any of your exams. And yes, if you like the video, do give it a thumbs up. And yes, if you have any more suggestions of new name reactions, you can just comment in the comment section below. And always visit the description, all right? You can visit my Unacademy profile, where we are having a lot of special classes. Now, those special classes are called, actually, they are the free classes, okay? Free live sessions, in which in this month of September, we are having a lot of good discussion, guys. And we are talking about organic reactions. Yes, we are talking about organic reactions. We are talking about organic spectroscopy. So even if you are, let's say, watching this video late, very late after September 2020, you will be able to access my profile and see the recordings. All of the free live sessions are recorded, yes? Alright guys, so definitely I'll see you very, very soon in the next video. Until then, keep on studying. And please like the video, share, and also subscribe if you already haven't. And join the Telegram group. The link is given in the description below. Till then, bye everyone, and see you very, very soon.